Welcome back, everyone. Today we are looking at the latest quad of the Betafpv Pavo series. The Pavo 20 Pro has many similarities with Pavo 20, yet there are many differences. Unboxing time, let's see what's inside the package. We have a lot to cover in this episode on this machine, and I also included a bonus section about a funny random encounter. So make sure you stick around until the end of the video, thanks. The lower frame of the quad came pre-assembled, ready to accept the O3 air unit, or other VTX, depending on the selection when you order. Pin IO controlled LED strip, a standard for the Pavo series. Mounting bracket, bolts, and dipole antennas. A spare set of 2.2-inch 3-blade propellers and an USB-C adapter. Lastly, the redesigned O3 cage. And that is everything. All parts at a glance. The pre-installed flight controller is the same one used in Pavo 20, the F4-2-3S-20A AIO FC V1. O3 cable with plug ready for plug and play. Socket for USB-C adapter at the rear, just like the Pavo 20. New Betafpv motors introduced for this new quad, Lava 1104, 7200 kV. Antenna passes through the bottom opening and then extends forward. We will see if reception will be impacted in test flights. It may be a little difficult to see. UART6 has already been wired up for the pin IO controlled LED strip. The capacitor also came pre-installed. Use a pair of tweezers carefully to fish the pin IO plug out. It could take some time with the capacitor in the way. The lower frame assembly seems quite a bit beefier than the Pavo 20s. It weighs 63.6 grams, about 2/3 of the Pavo 20's dry weight. $4.6 with the new O3 cage compared to $3.7 in the previous version. 5 grams for the pin IO LED strip. The LED strip is a signature feature of the Pavo. There is no reason not to install it being a larger quad. The hole still wouldn't clear the plug though. Use the other hand to pass through the opening instead. The LED wires are short, so we will route them and connect at the bottom side between the propellers. The socket plug sits snug in the slot. Start from the center of the curve in the middle and work your way around the ducts. Go slowly and make sure the strip is flat and straight. And you will find out that the cut line is right at where the starting point is. They clearly thought about getting the right length in the design. The strip's two ends push against each other in the middle, preventing them from separating. The strip should look seamless if installed correctly. Hook up Betaflight Configurator and see what has been sent already. Betaflight 4.5 came preloaded, barometer active. Gyro works. built-in receiver on UART3, O3 communication on UART4. UART6 has been remapped to control the pin IO LED strip, arming angle pre-configured. The differences worth noting are higher P&I gains. Looks like they were jacked up to stabilize in quick moves. Loosen the sticks for smoothness while limiting dynamic damping. Midpoint value for anti-gravity. Receiver tab was already set up. Just bind and fly. Even modes were predefined. To control the pin IO LED strip, simply enter your range in user 1 and you are all set. If everything is done correctly, here we go. Whoa, what a surprise. Blue looks quite nice and very bright for a 5V LED. The switch works right off the bat without going through the resource mapping exercise. New O3 cage with a stretched design. Additional mounting holes for seating the camera higher to avoid ducks in view. This can be useful for low tilt angle flying. More space between the camera and the VTX with the Pavo emblem in between. Beefed up antenna holders for both dipoles and mushroom styles. Metal mounting nuts embedded in the cage just like the Pavo 20. Let's install the O3. The VTX snaps in easily and it is held in place without the mounting bolts. The antenna holder has a slot opening for the wires to pass through, an improvement from the original. Push the antenna in while making sure the wires aren't overly bent at the plugs. All mounting holes have raised edges, the bolts stick out a little and are easier to work with. When using the lower holes, not all ND filters would fit between the lens guards on both sides. So make sure to pick up the ones that can be mounted vertically or use the top holes instead. Camera sticks further out when using the top holes. The camera is no longer protected by the lens guards though. Time to deal with these little rubber grommets again. An easy way is to jam it partially into the hole first. Push it in using a toothpick or something not too pointy. Finally, secure the cage assembly onto the lower frame. It may be easier to plug in the O3 cable before installing the cage. Pavo 20 Pro isn't a whole lot bigger than the original. With the cage stretched, VTX sits further back while the camera moves to the front to maintain balance of CG. Slight increase in size of the carbon plate to accommodate the 2.2-inch props. Arms and struts got thicker. Pavo 20 Pro's strut measures about 3.1 millimeters in width, 2 millimeters in thickness. Pavo 20's is at 2.6 millimeters in width, 2 millimeters in thickness. Pavo 20 Gemfan 2015 biblade feels very stiff. Pavo 20 Pro's Gemfan 2218 tri-blade is much more flexible in comparison. Let's weigh both to see the difference. Pavo 20 has dipoles, O3 antennas, and lightweight Velcro as battery strap. At 95.7 gram dry, Pavo 20 Pro with stock O3 antenna, heavier 1104 motors, larger 3-blade props, and regular battery strap. At 114 gram dry, about 20% increase. Being a ducted quad, we will start off with some cinematic shots. The flexible props, motors, and PID tune make it very smooth and tame. The additional mass also helps with a little more inertia. Noise level and pitch are higher. still acceptable when hovering or cruising. With more mass and power, it is even easier to pick up speed and penetrate moderate wind. Controlled punch out followed by a spiral descent, this flies like it is on rail. Smooth like a hot knife slicing through butter, yet the throttle feels a little slow. Throttle response is indeed slower than expected, yikes! While higher and gradual moves like this are decent and a joy to pull off, very tight ones with at low altitude can be trouble with this tune and props though. On the other hand, the tameness makes close proximity and precision maneuvers easy. So I'd say it is perfectly capable for indoor flying, just like the original. Flight time varies depending on flying style. For cruising around, I'm getting 5 minutes with a 500 mAh 3S pack. An improvement of about 15%. So can we still fly harder with this? Only one way to find out. High dives are still very doable, just ease out earlier when recovering. Maximum thrust on the Pavo 20 Pro is greater while the response is similar to the original. Pay attention to the upcoming side-by-side test with both quads at maximum throttle. Get ready, hit the gas. Both punched out at similar speed in the first second or two. Prop wash handling is much better with the Pro. While it is not designed to be a 4S powerhouse, it takes almost everything that I threw at it. With the ELRS antenna sandwiched between the frame and the pack, LQ barely moves at 350 meter out while close to the ground. However, the result can be very different in high interference areas, even at short distance. The Pavo 20 Pro can take a lot of punishment. I crashed it into the ground and even hard objects multiple times. Even did it backward like this one, and it walked away unscathed. I cannot believe that I am doing the flight of shame again. Not even a broken prop now, that is impressive. The Pavo 20 Pro is a leap from the original. A very steady platform for cinematic shots for its size. Enhanced aerobatics capability and wind penetration, longer flight time on the same packs. The quad is built like a tank. The new 03 cage produced zero footage with Jello in my test. Throttle response could use some improvement. Maybe adding some feed forward or use stiffer props. Please let me know your comment and subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you. Wait, there is more. The LED strip makes it pretty approachable to people of all ages. This family group was having a party by the shore and invited me to join. Quick flip to a low rate profile. Turn the Pavo 20 Pro into a party animal. Let's have fun and I will see you in the next one.